Thank you very much. Madam Chair, thank you, Commissioner, for the work you do and testimony you're providing. So as we look at a growing mandate for the reasons we've heard and so many others, speak just briefly to something I've worked with the department on going back many years to the coordination, especially with New York City, which as we know is a central target, has been centrally impacted by Sandy and other severe emergencies, and has in its NYPD one of the great counterterrorism programs in the nation, and in its own Office of Emergency Management, a very, very sophisticated emergency response system. How is that coordination with the City of New York going?
Excellent.
Great. And so that's true vis-a-vis NYPD?
Yes, it is. I meet with Chief Waters regularly, the Chief of Counterterrorism. Superintendent D'Amico of the State Police and I are good friends. We converse often about those types of issues. And the cooperation between the Office of Emergency Management in New York City, the Police Department, and us is outstanding.
Great. And the Office of Fire Protection and the FDNY?
Perfect.
Excellent. I passed a bill a number of years ago that produced a report about some of the real dangers to residents in New York City and FDNY to the fact that state buildings, buildings under the state code in New York City are not covered by the city building code, historically did not have shared building plans, which meant that tragically in my district when FDNY went to respond to a fire at 130 Liberty Street at the World Trade Center site, they didn't have the same plans on file they would for another high-rise fire, in that case leading to truly tragic consequences. There had been a plan to embed state Office of Fire Protection personnel with FDNY in their emergency response so that it was much easier to coordinate that information up front and make sure that we weren't putting FDNY personnel at risk and were ensuring the kind of safety in state buildings we have in city buildings. Is that program still continuing? And what confidence can we have that FDNY is going to have the same information going into a building under state jurisdiction as it does every other building in the city?
Can you just provide some context as far as date for that, Senator? Because I've only been here a year, and I don't know
sure,
if that goes
yeah,
way
that,
back.
That report, I believe, came out in 2012, and then through 2012 and 13, and into the beginning of 2014, we worked with then Commissioner Cassano and Hauer on this quite extensively.
Okay. I'm going to have to get back to you if that's okay, Senator. I know there was some issue about state buildings in the city, and it was a legal issue that our legal team was looking at. I don't know if it's the same issue that you're referring to, maybe, but I don't have an answer for you.
Okay. Well, this is a critically important issue.
Okay.
We need a path to solution here, and we can't, you know, rely on sort of the status quo or on, you know, bureaucratic attempts to hold on to one role or the other. The fact is, building plans are available to FDNY when they get an emergency in every building in the city, unless it's not under city jurisdiction, which means all the state buildings, the Port Authority buildings, the buildings at the World Trade Center site, are not automatically shared in that way.
Okay.
Further, some of the rules and the consistency between the rules or the processes for how you create safe buildings or fire-safe buildings are not the same, and therefore can create concerns and risks both for the users of those buildings and for emergency personnel who are responding. This is something that has to be better coordinated than it has been in the past. We started that process, and it sounds like, and thank you for your sort of straightforwardness in this answer, it's not clear that process has been completed in a way that's sufficient. So I would love a report on where that is and why it is that we can have more comfort now than a half decade ago when tragic consequences ensued and firefighters lost their lives at 130 Liberty Street related to this issue.
Yeah, don't misunderstand me, Senator. I don't know if that issue has been resolved. I do know that we have a wonderful working relationship between our Office of Fire Prevention and Control and the FDNY. I would assume that if it was some critical issue as you described, I would be aware of it. I really haven't heard. I know there was an issue about building inspections or something, but
exactly
hadn't risen to the level of a a really critical problem that I certainly would hope that I would be aware of. So it may be solved, it may be done, but I guarantee I'll get back to you.
And you know, one of the issues is a long-standing problem folks have gotten used to, which doesn't mean it's not a problem, but does mean that sometimes it doesn't rise to the level of an alarm bell being rung. It's smoldering as opposed to really burning out of control right now, but let's stop it while it's smoldering. So I'll look forward to some feedback and follow up on where we are with that issue.